Let the same mind be in you that was in Christ Jesus, who, though he was in the form of God, did not regard equality with God as something to be exploited, but emptied himself, taking the form of a slave, being born in human likeness. And being found in human form, he humbled himself and became obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross. Loving and redeeming God, creator and sustainer of all, we know your love is over every creature your hands have made. Your desire is not to destroy, but to save, not to condemn, but to forgive. You gather us all with our hurts, our sins and failures, our pain and distress, and carry our load in your own broken body so that we may be free and begin new life in you. For this we give you thanks and praise. Amen. Thank you. A reading from Luke 23. As they led him away, they seized a man, Simon of Cyrene, who was coming from the country, and they laid the cross on him and made him carry it behind Jesus. Two others also, who were criminals, were led away to be put to death with him. When they came to the place of the skull, they crucified Jesus there with the criminals, one on his right and one on his left. Then Jesus said, "Father, forgive them, for they know not what they are doing." And they cast lots to divide his clothing. And the people stood by watching, but the leaders scoffed at him, saying, "He saved others. Let him save himself if he is the Messiah of God, the chosen one." The soldiers also mocked him, coming up and offering him sour wine and saying, "If you are the King of the Jews, save yourself." There was also an inscription over him, "This is the King of the Jews." One of the criminals who were hanged there kept deriding him and saying, "Are you not the Messiah? Save yourself and us." But the other rebuked him, saying, "Do you not fear God, since you are under the same sentence of condemnation? And we indeed have been condemned justly, for we are getting what we deserve for our deeds. But this man has done nothing wrong." Then he said, "Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom." Lord Christ, to whom should we go? You have the words of eternal life. Lord Christ, may your word enlighten us. You tell us you are the salt of the earth. Lord Christ, may your word enlighten us. You tell us to love our enemies. Lord Christ, may your word enlighten us. You tell us to do good to those who hate you. Lord Christ, may your word enlighten us. You tell us to pray, ask, seek, and you will find. Lord Christ, may your word enlighten us. This day we especially pray for our community and for those suffering during the pandemic all over the world. We pray for those in the wars in foreign lands. We pray for the end of suffering. We pray for those who are suffering from illness or injury and all who are grieving. Lord Christ, you tell us, seek first the kingdom of God. May your word enlighten us. We pray together the prayer Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Thank you.
May the peace of Christ go with you today. May you always walk in his light. Go into the world in peace to love and serve the Lord. Amen.